Welcome to the Trading with a Bot channel. Let's look at the crash of the crypto market that happened on May 19th of 2021. There's an evident downtrend here already from the beginning of the May, but it is on the May 19th that Bitcoin and most of the other currencies that dropped within a very short period of time. The price of the Bitcoin had fell by 30%, and the Dogecoin had plunged up to 45%, all within extremely short time frame. This drop had caused a complete liquidation of funds for many of the crypto traders. When you trade on futures using leverage, and you do not have enough maintenance balance to support a falling price of your position is terminated with a liquidation, and your future balance is taken as a payment, thus leaving you with zero in your balance. In other words, you lose your position, and your money, and you're left with nothing. The drop on Dogecoin was even more severe than on the Bitcoin. This chart is showing that the Dogecoin had a straight fall by 40%. While the price recovered quickly, even a second of such a drop on the futures platform, while trading with leverage, would be sufficient to liquidate most of the positions and strategies, including the tiny Doge bot that I had introduced to you in my past videos. In this video, I want to examine closer how the tiny Doge bot, or generally speaking, how a DCA bot handles severe price falls. There's a backtesting script created by one of the TradingView users that I've shown you last time. Unfortunately, it will not offer a lot of help here, but let me remind you of the settings that I used in the tiny Doge bot, and re-enable the overlay of the indicator. I am opening my first safety order at 2.7% below the base order, and I scale the subsequent safeties with a factor of 0.7. This bot has opened new trade ASAP starting condition. I've covered all of these settings in my last two videos, and if you've missed them, I have link in the description. Now, let me set the backtesting time frame for just before the crash had happened. In the previous video, I had shown how to use this backtester to see how different settings of the safety orders will impact your overall net profit. I continue to use it often to find the best settings for different coins, but there is a different tool that I use to understand the liquidation risks of my DCA bots. So I will not focus on the net profit now, but rather we'll try to show you visually how the base order and the safety orders were placed during this dive. The open new trade ASAP DCA bots work non-stop. They buy at market price, sell at the defined target profit level, and then buy again. Here, where I am pointing now, is where the base order was opened, right after the previously closed transaction with take profit. And I want to examine this particular fragment of time, because here the price was going straight down. There's the first, second, third, fourth, fifth and sixth safety orders, all were triggered one by one. As I measure this, you'll see that within about 10 minutes, the price went straight down by more than minus 25%. This is the main risk for a DCA bot, when the price crashes continuously, as I am showing now. I will switch to the three commas interface, and examine the settings that are responsible for the construction of the safety orders grid. I'll do calculations of the grid's positions manually, and will draw them for you on the price chart. Let me snap this section here first. Next, I want to point out the section here on the right top corner, with the assistant, chart and table information. My total Binance futures balance is $25. I only have this one DCA bot running on this account, and thus I am comfortable to use the cross settings for my leverage type. If the market crashes, I will lose these $25. I am aware of it, and I accept this risk. In the next 10 minutes, or so, I want to show you how to measure the drop in price, where I would face a liquidation. When the price goes down, you continue to open new safety orders, and thus the size of your overall position continues to increase. Such increase in the position size is necessary. As you buy more with a lower price, you bring down the average cost of the coin, and thus only a small price recovery will be sufficient for you to sell with a profit. This table feature in the three commas interface is extremely useful. Here is, for instance, the column showing the average price of the Doge coin. As I continue to open a position with a larger size, on each consecutive safety order. And here you can see the necessary recovery percent, in order for the DCA bot to close the accumulated positions with a profit. But if the recovery does not happen, and the price continues to fall straight down, your accumulated position will require larger and larger maintenance balance, until, you possibly, will run out of money and be liquidated. I'll snap this section as well, and we'll start a manual calculation, where I will continue to explain how the safety order settings affect the grid construction. Now, in Excel file, I want to put these two tables side by side. A section that I snapped with the safety orders configurations, and the table from the DCA assistant feature. Here you can see how the different fields relate to each other. Price deviation to open safety orders, percent from initial order is shown in the deviation percent column. The safety order volume scale is represented in the size column. And now I'll construct a table and perform some simple math calculations to show how these values change, row by row. I want to use the specific scenario from May 19th that we had just discussed, so I will pull up the price that the Doge had, just before the dump. Let me turn off the indicator labels. I plan to draw my own grid lines now. Here's an approximate price level, where the first base order had taken place. I will mark it with a white vertical line, in the trading view. It's an approximation, but it will serve the purpose. So, the price of the base order is 0.33472. This price will act as a starting point for the rest of my calculations. Let's focus on how the price deviation to open safety orders value influences the safety orders construction. We know that the first safety order will be opened 2.7% below the base order, so I'll write this down. 2.7% multiplied by 0.34472 is 0.0093, and that's the price deviation. So the first safety order will be 0.34472 minus 0.0093. And that's 0.3354. The three commas table feature calculates all of this for you, but I am doing it manually, because I am calculating for the base order price before the dump of May 19th. I'll go back to the trading view price chart, and copy the first line that I created, but adjust its labels and coordinates. This will now illustrate our first safety order position. I think you're starting to see the point that I want to illustrate. While on a regular day, a drop in a 2.7% may seem significant, on May 19th it looks like a very small step. Now let's calculate the price for the second safety order. It's a bit more complex now, because after the first SO, all other SOs need to follow the safety order step scale that you had specified in your bot settings. I now need to combine the values by multiplying them. I multiply the price deviation percent, which I set to 2.7, and safety order step scale, which I set to 0.7. And thus, my second safety order will be opened 1.89% below the first safety order. If I add up 1.89 and 2.7, I'll have a total of 4.59%, that you also see in three commas table here. This table shows the total deviation from the base order, not the deviation between the safety orders. Now I'll use this deviation percent to calculate the new price level for the second safety order, and I will plot this second SO on the chart. I am fast-forwarding the video, and cutting a bit, to speed up, and show you the final result. Each time I multiply the safety order step scale value by deviation percent of the previous safety orders. And each time the resulting deviation becomes smaller. As a result, the safety orders grids become narrower and narrower. The reason for is because safety order step scale is less than 1, specifically in my case it is 0.7. If it was exactly 1, the space between my grids would always be 2.7%. And if it was larger than 1, the space between the safety orders would be wider and wider. Now here is the final picture of how the bot would operate during the market crash. It would have opened all of the 6 safety orders based on the bot's configuration, but as you can see, the price would continue to go down. I had designed the tiny Doge bot with only 6 safety orders, because I wanted to limit the budget that the bot would use, I had also specified a narrowing safety order grid, because under the normal market conditions this specific configuration produces a relatively high profit. On May 19th, however, my tiny Doge would be out of safeties within minutes, and then the price would drop by another 27%. Since my balance would have been only $25, I would have been liquidated. If you now have a good understanding of how the safety order's configuration affects the construction of your DCA bot, I'd like to show you the Binance Futures Anti-Liquidation Calculator. This is one of the third-party tools, not affiliated with 3Commas, but the developer had done a great job capturing the effects of the price drops on the budget of your DCA bot. With this tool, we'll finally answer the question of how much money you need to allocate to a bot when trading with leverage. Here I will replicate the settings of my tiny Doge bot. My wallet balance is $25, and my base and safety order sizes are both equal to $5. I had chosen Dogecoin from the drop-down list, and the calculator had automatically pulled up Doge's latest price. Next, I have 6 safety orders, my leverage is set to 50, price deviation is at 2.7%, safety order volume scale is 1.9, and my safety order step scale is 0.7. These are the settings of my tiny Doge bot. The balance that I need for this bot is $22.15. This is what the calculator computed based on the inputs I had provided now. The bot info section provides the same information that is available in 3Commas. With the 6 SOs, my bot will invest the maximum amount of $6, which turns out to be $266 when using the 50x leverage. And, with grid scale of 6 SOs, my bot will cover the price decrease of -7.94%. During the normal market fluctuations, 7.94% is already an extreme situation of a straight price decrease. Here you can see this very same information in 3Commas table interface. The total price deviation that all my safety orders will cover is 7.94%. Note that I am speaking of a straight price decrease or a drop. If, at any point of time, the prices recovers by about 2%, the bot will sell the whole position and start anew, but now thankfully from a lower price point. A gradual decrease the bot will handle just fine. It is a crash-like scenario, as we have seen on May 19th, that we want to be careful with. As you recall, the price had dropped by another 27%, after the last safety order. The liquidation calculator that I've shown to you has a field called additional percentage price drop after filled the last SO. If the price drops down by additional 27%, as we've seen, my total reserve requirements to avoid the liquidation will increase to $84.50. This is the amount that I will need to have in my futures maintenance balance to keep my bot alive. You can also see that in total, when I have $84 in my reserve, my bot can handle a price drop of 34.94%. Lastly, there's a base order and safety orders section below, which does a similar calculation as I had performed in the first half of this video. I will leave the link to this webpage below in the description of the video, and I strongly recommend you make use of this tool when budgeting your DCA bots. Here you can see the exact price of the Dogecoin, at which my position would be terminated. Since I had kept the setting of my wallet equal to $25, my liquidation price is 0.2562, which is 7.7% below my last safety. There is no liquidation if I change back the additional drop price to 5%. A straight drop in a total of 12.94% is handled just fine. And this is how you use this anti-liquidation calculator. You can change other settings, such as safety order count, and see how it expands the range of drops that the bot can handle. An additional safety order will also require additional capital, and this you see in the recommended minimum wallet balance section. One of my goals today was to show you that the risk of liquidation is real. The tiny Doge bot that I had introduced 2 weeks ago had been adapted by many people, based on the feedback that I had received. This adaptation included an increase of base and safety order sizes, and also trying the bot with other coins. I've heard a lot of positive feedback about the performance of such tiny bots. Here, however, I wanted to show you that they are not without a risk. My main goal, however, was to show you how the safety order settings impact the behavior of the bot, and how you can use a tool, such as anti-liquidation calculator, to know exactly how much budget you require, and at which price level you are risking the liquidation. Once again, I thank you for your attention, and for your feedback. Much of what I had learned myself was through the feedback and the pointers from the crypto community that we are building together. Till next time.